Hello friends, this video on classification of elements part 13 is brought to you by examfea.com. No more fear from exam. Before watching this video, please make sure that you have watched part 1 to part 12. Let's discuss the D block elements. So group 3 to group 12 elements are my D block elements. And they are characterized by filling of D orbitals. The outermost orbital is the D orbital. And they have the electronic configuration something like this, n-1, d 1 to 10, and then my s 0 to 2. So we see all these elements I am showing, right? The d orbitals are the one which get filled. So if you see the electronic configuration, these are my d has 1 to 10 and then s, right? So here also we see. See, don't get confused with this picture actually. If you see the order, 1s, then I have 2s, then I have 2p, then I have 3s, and then I have 3p, and then I have 4s, and then I have 3d. This is the last orbital actually. Right? Because the way I have written this in this case is all 1 first, all 2, all 3, all 4. This order is not the increasing order of energy, but if you see the increasing order of energy, this is the last orbital. After 3d, I have 4p, so let me put it here. Then I have 5s, then I have 4d, and then we have 5p, which is not there. So this is my order actually. So if you see in this case, this is my last orbital. In all these elements, if you see these elements, if you see these are my last orbitals, correct. And if you see, here also it is 4d and here also it is d. Hope you understand. See, this order was intensely taken in this because in all the other slides I have taken this as the increasing order of energy, right? But in this case I have not taken this. Just to show that, don't be confused with the order in which it is maintained. Just you have to make sure, even if it is not in the order of increasing order, you have to write arrow like this and make sure that you follow the pattern. And with this, if you see, right, the last orbital is 3d here, and in this case the last orbital is 4d, correct. And if we take electronic configuration of any of these elements, example, if you take the scandium, right, 21, so it will be 1s2, 2s2, 2p6, 3s2, 3p6, then becomes 4s2, 3d, right. So if this is my electronic configuration, this is my last element, and this is in d block, d orbital, so it is d block. And also if you see the electronic configuration I have, for example here n is going to, if you put 4, so this becomes 3d 1 to 10 and 4s2, right, or 0 to 2. So here if you see, my configuration matches. Correct. Actually in real world, if you go by the energy, it should be ns0 to 2 and n-1 d1 to 2. Correct, because in general that's the case, it is for n is greater than or equal to 4. Correct, because 4s has lower energy than this guy, 3d. Let's see the properties of this d block. They all metals, hard and ductile with high melting and boiling points. They got transition elements. Correct. Why? Because they are the bridge between chemically active s block and the less active ones. Their ionization energy is between S and P block. We will discuss what this is all about, ionization energy, but just understand that S energy, we have S, P and D, and we will have to discuss about the ionization energy. We will discuss in the next few slides. And they also show variable oxidation state. This concept will be clear in the next chapter when we discuss about the actual reactions. They form both ionic and covalent bonds. They generally colored and paramagnetic. And most they generally form colorless complexes and they are used as catalysts. These are the chemical or physical properties of the D block elements. Correct? They are called transition elements, transition metals. They are all metals. Please note, they are all metals. We'll talk about the F block elements. So they are generally, I have lanthanides and actinides. They are the F block elements. There are two rows of elements at the bottom of the periodic table, and they have this electronic configuration. In this case, the last electron is added to F orbit, and they are all metals. Right? These are my F block elements. So if you see these, all these elements, again, if you see, I have just written this in not in the increasing energy order. So let's do that. 1s, 2s, and 2p, and 3s, 3p, 4s, and 3d, 4p, 5s, 4d, 5p, 6s, 4f. This guy is my last orbit, right? After a 4f, I have 5d. 5d also. Right? So if you see, generally if you see in all these, my exceptions are my GD and LU, where my 5D is the one which is getting filled. But apart from these, the last one in all these are P-valves. Correct? 4F. So 4F is the last. This is there because my in case of this guy TB, this gets half filled. So since this gets half filled, it gets extra stability. But these are the exceptions. I can say these are the exceptions, but generally these are the ones which get last filled. So the electronic configuration is of this pattern: n minus 2f from 1 to 14, n minus d, n minus 1d can have 0 to 1 element, and ns2 can have two elements. Sorry, it is 0 to 10 actually. 0 to 10. Correct. Let's discuss the properties of these F block elements. They are very heavy metals with very high melting and boiling points. They also show variable oxidation state, which we'll learn in the next class. They are generally colored compounds. They have tendency to form complexes. And these two series are called inner transition elements. And the actinides are more complicated than lanthanides. These guys are more complicated than lanthanides because the large number of oxidation states are possible for this actinides. And these are generally radioactive actinides. And these are very made very, very small quantities, and they are even less, and they are made by nuclear reactions. And these elements we don't study much because they are not available much in nature also. Most of these are synthesized in lab only, right? And elements after uranium, these guys are called trans-uranium elements. So not much important for us because we don't use it much. Thank you. Visit examfear.com to watch free educational videos, try free online tests, get the best quality study materials, study from the best tutors and mentors, and much more. Thanks once again.